Greetings. This video refutes argument number one from the random flood list sent by the Mohammedan. Let's look at the claim for argument number one. According to the Word of God, the Bible, Jesus was sent to give the world a sword, not peace, Matthew 10:34. But according to Muhammad's Quran, Muhammad was sent to give the world peace. Let's consider the purpose of this argument. It is first trying to accuse the Bible, the Word of God, because God's message regarding Jesus. Second, this argument attempts to claim Muhammad is a man of peace because of a quote from Muhammad about himself. First, let's take a look at what Matthew 10:34 says in context. Matthew 10:32 and 33. Whosoever therefore shall confess me, meaning Jesus, before men, him will I confess also before my Father which is in heaven. But whoso shall deny me before men, him will I also deny before my Father which is in heaven. So we see here, Jesus calls God his Father. Okay, that's the same as saying he is the Son of God. That's one reason why Mohammedans don't read the context. So here we see that Jesus is clearly establishing something. If you confess Jesus, the Son of God, before men, Jesus will confess you before God, his Father. But if you deny Jesus, the Son of God, before men, Jesus will also deny you before God, his Father. And after Matthew 10:34, Jesus says this, Matthew 10:35-36, "For I am come to set a man at variance against his father, and the daughter against her mother, and the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law, and a man's foes shall be they of his own household." Verse 37 and 38, "He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me, and he that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he that taketh not his cross, and followeth after me, is not worthy of me." Look closely and you'll see three times Jesus says, who is worthy of him, and what it takes to be worthy of Jesus. Again, Jesus is clearly teaching a principle. Jesus is saying, you have a choice to make. If you value your father or mother above Jesus, you are not worthy of him. Jesus is saying you have a choice to make. But does this somehow malign the Bible? Why is this offered up by a Mohammedan as if this makes the Bible look bad? Heavens no, it doesn't make the Bible look bad. There's nothing to be ashamed of in this verse. The Bible accurately records what Jesus wanted you to learn. You must have no one before God. You must have no one before Jesus. This is the first commandment revealed by Moses. Do not have any other gods before me. But here is the problem for those who place Muhammad before Jesus. They refuse to understand the Trinity. So they wrongly think Jesus is a separate God. But by correctly examining Jesus' teaching, it makes perfect sense. If you place anyone before Jesus, your father, your mother, your sister, your brother, your mother-in-law, if you place anyone before Jesus, you are in fact placing them before God. Also, as far as this argument is concerned, The Bible calls Jesus the Prince of Peace. Prince of Peace. Isaiah 9:6. His name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. So this verse is kind of a puzzler to you Mohammedans. How can His name be the Mighty God and the Prince of Peace? Well, if it's talking about Almighty God, wouldn't He be the King of Peace? If it was talking about God the Father, Almighty God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Yahweh, wouldn't He be the King of Peace? That's not who this verse is talking about. And yet it calls the Prince of Peace the Mighty God. Think about it. Jesus Christ, the Prince of Peace, the Son given, His name, Jesus, His name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Jesus came as the Prince of Peace. That doesn't mean you won't have a little bit of conflict to follow the Prince of Peace. You have a decision to make. So this argument is really another foolish misrepresentation of the Word of God. Do I need to prove Muhammad was not a man of peace? The Quran is Muhammad's message, his words, his only. Is Muhammad a man of peace because Muhammad said he was? No! If you call yourself Muslim, I have some sincere questions for you. Do you know one of the 99 names of your Allah is Al-Haq, the truth? Do you place any value in the truth? To make this kind of argument, argument number one, to ignore context, to ignore Prophet Isaiah's words, you must despise the message of the prophets. You are ignoring the message of the prophets. Are you embarrassed that argument number one displays such willful ignorance of the context? Well, I am embarrassed for you that this is the way Mohammedism must attack the message of the gospel of Jesus, the Injil. If you have any respect for the truth, my friend, look and see how Islam behaves. Look at it. Really look at it. Such behavior is not from God. A religion founded on such behavior is not from God. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.